Hey guys, it's Sophie from the Pug Girls, and today I'm going to be doing school life hacks because why not? Because, like, you know, because I know a few of you guys watching are people who I've told about my channel and tell that about at school. So, yeah, this first one I figured out when I was jokingly trying to erase a math problem in like third grade off my homework, and it worked. So yeah, I ended up having to rewrite that, so I wouldn't get an F, but still, it's really good if you just, like, let's say you were in a mad panic, wrote with a marker, and made a mistake. Like, I would not do it instead of whiteout if you have a big thing, but like, for example, just writing and instead of A, for example. So I'm gonna switch the camera around to show you how it works. So pretty much all you need, well, you need ink that you're gonna be erasing, and you need a pencil with a functional eraser and lead. Let's see that. So pretty much what you do, it might take a few tries, but you will be able to do it. So you have to, like, scribble down really dark on what you're trying to erase. And it's like, once it actually starts working, oh, why is it being so hard? Might take a few tries, but eventually you will get some results. There will usually be some sort of dark smudge, but if you're really in a panic, this would be some really life-saving work.
Okay, so this next one is mostly for when you're in middle school like me, and you have to start getting really big notebooks. This is a three-subject notebook. It's much bigger. Let's see if I have any smaller ones. Oh, nope. But yeah, it's much bigger than you have in elementary school, so getting used to finding stuff, if you just, for those times where you just open it up to a random blank page like this, you will never be able to find what you write. But this is flawless. Just I'm just writing the name of my old channel. Then, I left my highlighter at school today, so I'm going to be using this beautiful blue marker. And so you get it so you have just the individual page. You don't have to do the entire thing, but you just color the top of it. And it may seem like, oh, it's just a tiny line, it won't do anything. But it's how I keep organized, and even though I just did the tiniest little line, but, like, watch. Can you spot the blue line? Yep. And then I'll just go to that page, and you will have it again. Now, where did I put that marker cap before I set this down? Beautiful, disorganized life. Green, yellow, and blue. And I went to the back side of the blue, of course I did. Beautiful. So yeah, that was my second tack. And wow, that one took a long time. So yeah, I will see you guys for the next hack. Okay, so this next one is for those people who get a school iPad for their school, and which is like mine, and with all the apps they assign you, it gets insanely stressful. So, like, how do you keep track of all of them? Well, what I do is, because you, when you pick a background, you usually want to be able to see it, because you choose it for a reason. So I do it like this. I make a classes section. Oh my gosh, before eyes. So this is like study stuff. Geography, reading, science, music, testing, math. So then, in just a click of a finger, you'll have everything right there that you need. So that is one of the ones I use. It's like, I use it the second to most. So this last one, you would do it with a paper towel tube or maybe a chunk of a wrapping paper tube. But I guess one of my family members saw the paper towel tube that I was going to use, but sadly I left it on my bed, which is by my gerbil cage, which is right over there. So, yeah, and it's not like we use paper towels that fast, so I'm just going to be demonstrating on this since I don't even have my locker with me. So pretty much, you measure the inside of your locker precisely. It's better to have it too big and too small because it's being like stuck on the side like this. It'll keep it up. If it's too small, then it will fall right out. And this you like shove into your locker. And pretty much the point, you can put pretty much anything on it. Bracelets or scrunchies. And then you'll just take it out whenever you need to use one. And you'll have that right there inside your locker, which for people like me, it's really easy to have this type of thing where you can just quickly grab before class. Like, I don't know, if you stop at your locker, drop stuff before gym, or you put it in your gym locker, then you can have a hair tie right there. You don't have to be scrambling with only 3 minutes to go from room to room. So that is a super good one. And now I have to go search for a mechanical pencil for the next one. Yeah, things you need for the next one. Nerds. And a mechanical pencil. And, yeah. So I will be right back to you when I find those things. So, peace. Okay, since I cannot find the nerds, I'm just going to show you how to sneak putty into class. So, I'm using the putty from my most popular YouTube video on my other channel. It's Neon Flash. Really awesome. So I'm going to be showing you how you can sneak some awesome putty slime or whatever into the classroom. So, no! Honestly, you don't need that much. All you need is a pencil and a little bit, and you just spread it around. Just be kind of even and cannot look like a child made it, if you are a child. Because it's pretty much you're making it look like a grip for your pencil. So then, you could have some good putty to fidget with, but whenever your teacher comes by, well, you just pull out and start, you know, drawing with it, whatever, because, still, yeah, so those actually work as a good pencil grip, though. So you can use it as a pencil grip, or you can use a pencil grip disguised to sneak putty into a classroom. So was that hack number 5? Let me check. Yep, that was hack number 5. So, see you guys tomorrow. Technically, since I filmed this a day early, see you guys in 2 days. But for you guys, tomorrow. So, peace.